time around, we want all the money. This time around, we want all the money. This time around, we want all the money. This time around, we want all the money. 26 and all of them, watch on their wrists and all of them.
Children and for adults. That's probably not the best wording for that.
What you do is put ice in it, put that in there. When you shake it and you pour it out, it'll come out milky white and called lion's milk.
Over under 500.
Oh, under.
Ooh, I don't know. Actually, it might be.
I think the winning total is 429.40.
Let's go!
Absolute fuego, McFuegerson, dude.
All right. What a brokey. Can't even fix his own truck.
Dude, what the good fucking morning. It's like 2 o'clock already.
2 o'clock on a Saturday. The fuck are you doing?
Come check this out. Let's crunch some numbers. Divided by 2.
Breakfast first.
42K per month. In the next 6 months, should be about 42K per month if the numbers add up.
What does that do for breakfast, though?
Let's go get some breakfast. Count up the bands sticking up. No rubber band is big enough. Chain is so heavy, can pick it up. Came with the gang, myriad. I see you with lit. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Millionaire in the Making, vlog number 2. My name is Gage, for those of you who don't know me. And today we have a very special video. It's actually Justin's 28th birthday. It's probably going to get a little wild. He's a wild dude. Let's just get into it.
So, we're here to get bread and Pedialyte and Pepto.
For what?
Because I'm a professional. Anytime you're going to have a noticeable drinking session, you want to chug Pedialyte the moment you get home. Look, I'm telling you. Bread. We got like 20 people going. Bring at least 2 loaves of bread. Pedialyte. Pedialyte.
Jesus Christ, you need Pepto still?
Yes. Tell us you're alcoholics without telling us you're alcoholics.
Sounds like it looks kind of appetizing.
It's actually not bad.
Hello, looking for Ace.
Ace?
Ace.
Oh, so we social meeting?
Yes. It's a gold bottle of champagne. Yeah. Oh, y'all had it?
I got the fake one.
Oh, wait. Yeah, you do.
Oh, yeah, there it is. Black bag.
Let me introduce you to the world's finest. Always get the one that's in the bag. This is my little birthday present for myself. Happy birthday.
It's $369.50.
All right, so we're doing a little bit of a bit for this part of the video. As most of you know, Justin is absolutely addicted to Snapchat. Like, I'm talking, this dude, Snapchat's peeing. Snapchat's eating. Snapchat's him saying hey to his dad. Whatever it is, he's gonna Snapchat it, and I guarantee you there's gonna be a shit ton of them tonight. So what we're gonna do is go one by one by one. Everybody that's at the party, we're gonna ask them how many Snapchats they think Justin will have posted by the end of the night. So first up, we got Mason. What you think?
Basing it off of how many times.
Yeah, just taps. The screen, just right? Taps.
It's hard because he's gonna take some long Snapchats.
I'm gonna lock in 67.
55, yeah.
All right, so we got locked in. I'm locking in mine 67. You said.
55.
All right, so we got Braden and Jesse out here. We're asking them how many individual taps on Justin's Snapchat before he goes to sleep. What's the number, guys?
I gotta say at least 83.
83, lock it in.
My lucky number's 43. I'm going with the low ball. I think he's gonna get so hammered. He's not gonna understand like how to work an iPhone.
I'd say like 78.
Yeah, my number's gonna be 73.
Oh, 38.
38, lock it in.
Yeah, I think he's gonna post 69 snaps.
We're going 75.
It's either asshole red, money blue.
Well, red is a statement color. It is your birthday.
Yeah, but it's cobalt blue.
Yeah.
I just like the red because it's like skin color, like a skin tone. Like
I intimidate the shit out of people.
Hold both of them up.
I think you wanna wear the red.
I think it's the red.
Wait,
yeah, you wore the blue last time.
How many glasses? No, I wore a different blue last time.
Let me see you on demon time.
I mean red.
Yeah.
It's the red. It's
yeah.
The red.
Crush a bit, little bit, roll it up, take a hit, feeling lit, feeling right.
2 a.m.
summer night. I don't care, hand on the wheel, driving drunk, I'm doing my thing, rolling the mid beside and out, living my life, getting out dreams. I'ma do just what I want, looking ahead, no turning back. People told me slow my roll, I'm screaming out, fuck that. I'm screaming out, fuck that. I'm screaming out, fuck that. Fuck that, fuck that, fuck that, fuck that.
listen, I know everything that shine ain't always gonna be gold. Hey, I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good. I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that shine ain't always gonna be gold. Hey, I'll be fine once I get it.
What's going on, guys? We just stopped at the Tom Thumb. It's about 11 o'clock, a little bit of a late night, but we're still on the way to Seville, probably 15 minutes out.
Honey buns!
We'll catch you there.
Okay, so here we are now, and it's been 10 years since I made my master plan. When I was 18 years old, I wasn't okay with where I was at. I was broke, lonely, depressed. Things were just not going right for me. So I painted a picture of what I wanted my life to look like in 10 years. I wanted $10 million worth of real estate. I wanted my dream house on the water. I wanted my dream car. I wanted my dream social network. I wanted all my friends to be able to have freedom, to be able to travel. I wanted a group of like-minded, strong individuals. And it took me a little bit under 10 years to hit that. I mean, I hit 25 rentals at 25 years old. That was one of my big goals too. And up until about a couple of weeks ago, it took me that long to build the life of my dreams. I barely hit my target by about a few weeks. I mean, the power of painting a picture for yourself in the future is huge, and it's been a rough ride, I'm not gonna lie. I've wanted to probably give up at least 100 times, minimum. I mean, there's been nights where I was up working until 3, 4 a.m. There was times where my business wasn't bringing in paychecks for 3 to 4 to 5 months at a time, and bank account was going down. Things weren't looking good for me. You know, I've had a lot of highs, I've had a lot of lows. 10 years into this entrepreneur journey, and the biggest advice that I can give to anybody would definitely be have long-term vision. Just because you're uncomfortable right now at this moment doesn't mean it's going to be forever. I mean, I probably was miserable 60 to 75% of the time when I first started out, but that number started slowly switching. And now I've built a life where if I don't want to go to work, I don't have to. If I want to sleep in until 12 o'clock, I can. If I want to go on a 3-month vacation and travel the world, I can. I don't do that right now because I'm still stuck in the grind and I'm not allowed to take days off, but I'm working on it. And I gave up 5 to 10 years of my life to be able to live a life of comfort for the rest of my life. So I sacrificed short-term pleasures for long-term wealth, and now my great-grandchildren will be able to benefit from the things that I've done these past 10 years. I'm at the point right now where my great-grandchildren don't have to work.
This time around we want all the money. This time around we want all the money. This time around we want all the money. 26 and all I'm loving. Watch on they wrists and all I'm fetish. We the real big dogs and y'all some puppies.